code quality matters. It's readability, testability. It's not only that people should understand it, they should also be able to refactor it.
That is Robert Sussman, the first ever guest that we put on the Salesforce Developer Podcast. I'm Josh Birk, your host of the Salesforce Developer Podcast. And here in the podcast, you'll hear stories and insights from developers for developers. Now, today, we're going to do a little bit of a special episode. It's going to be a shorter episode. We're going to take a little bit of a victory lap. This is our 101st episode. And what I'd really like to do is be able to reflect back on those last 100 episodes, talk a little bit about how we got there, and use that as an excuse to thank a few people along the way. Now, whenever I think about the podcast, I think about a night in New York City. I am walking back to a hotel with my good friend and then manager, Mary Scotton. We had just left a developer group meetup, and we were just kind of talking about some of the things that people had said and what we had heard and some of the stories and some of the projects. And Mary was like, you know, that would make a great podcast. And that's not the origin story of the podcast. That is one of the many reminders that Mary would give me that in her mind, this was a good idea. It's something that the community would like, and we should keep it in our mind and keep it moving forward. And I also want to thank Mary for being instrumental in helping us launch. Now, the origin story of the podcast really kind of goes back to conversations I would have with the formerly known as Button Click Admin, Mike Gerholt, currently the co-host of the Salesforce Admin Podcast. And I remember sitting across from a fire pit with Mike at one of our departmental all hands. And we just kind of started chatting about like what would a counterpart to the admin podcast look like if we produced something like that for the developer podcast. Speaking of Mike and co-host of the Salesforce Admin Podcast, I definitely want to give a shout out to the great Jillian Bruce. I shadowed Jillian in the early days when we were trying to figure out what we were going to do and how we were going to launch. And so she really taught me how to prep guests, research guests, and eventually interview guests. Now, speaking of format, we didn't really know what we were going to do in we've actually been talking about doing a podcast for, at this point, I believe, years. And originally, I wasn't even intended to be the host necessarily. We went through a couple of iterations of trying to see people who might be interested in it. Fun fact, one of the people that we talked to was the wonderful Leah McGowan-Hare. To this day, I'm not entirely sure that Leah wouldn't be doing a better job than I am at this right now because she's amazing. But I'm also so happy that Leah got to go off and do incredible things over at Trailhead. Now, other people I'd like to thank Arabella David, Ariana Faustini, and Karen Data Angel. And Karen, I've always said your last name like that because that's how it looks like on text. And so I apologize if I am mispronouncing it. Those are people over in developer marketing who really helped start crafting, you know, style and giving constructive feedback and criticism and, you know, just kind of helping figure out what worked and what didn't work. I would also like to thank Peter Chittum and his wonderful team of developer advocates / evangelists who are also in there in the early years to help give feedback and have also been a great source of content for the podcast itself. Now, I really needed all those people in the early years because at one point we weren't even sure, would we go weekly, would we go bi-weekly, or would we go monthly, would we do a seasonal thing? And eventually I decided, you know, we're going to try to mirror the admin podcast, so we're going to go weekly. But we weren't sure what the podcast was going to sound like at that point. And there are a lot of interesting avenues we went down the way. At one point, we thought maybe we'd do a long format, not an interview style necessarily, but like two people sort of talking to each other. I sort of decided the ecosystem has that already. And the whole goal was not to, you know, compete with any of the community podcasts, but if anything, hopefully help uplift them in the long run. And so we wanted to try to do something unique. We thought about a little Q&A between developer evangelists. There was one format involving a metronome, and I want to thank Arabella for talking me out of that one. I won't go into details, but I mean, metronome kind of speaks for itself. And, you know, eventually we started talking about these conversations that we wanted to have about internal products, community people, MVPs, people who are putting together interesting products. And if you go back to the launch, we finally launched Dreamforce 2019. We started working on that at the beginning of 2019. So it took us almost a whole year in order to get enough episodes that I was happy with how the podcast was going to sound. And if you go back to those first four interviews, so that's Robert Sosman, that's Dan Harrison, that's Fabian Talion, that's Jessica Murphy, those were intentionally indicative of the kind of diversity that we wanted to have in speakers, that we wanted to have in topics, that we wanted to have between highly technical content to talking about how the community helps itself teach and learn Salesforce. And so we have tried to kind of keep that diversity rolling as we went through those 100 episodes. And speaking of those 100 episodes, I want to thank my guests. I especially want to thank my early guests who were very patient with me learning the ropes of this. We had some long interviews that we cut down to short interviews. We are looking at possibly to re-release some of the long versions of those early episodes. Those early episodes were really reflective of me learning how to get a good podcast out and trying to have a lot of good control over how the episodes were actually being put together. We've since evolved into a more natural conversational flow. But even as I've been working through this, I've had guests do an interview under a blanket. I've had a guest do an interview in a closet. I've had guests go and change out chairs because their chairs were too squeaky. And so for everybody who has helped me go the extra mile in this pod, I just really want to thank you. And that includes everybody that I've ever put onto a mic. Of course, I would be remiss if I didn't thank my current leadership in the form of Christoph Konrads. He's just been wonderful in supporting the podcast and giving us time and bandwidth in order to get it done. I want to thank Heather Storm and her team. Heather's been a supporter of the podcast since before day one. Fun fact, Heather told me that she wasn't really a podcast person, but she would try to give it a listen. And so a lot of my conceptual work was like, how can we win Heather over to the podcast, which I believe we've been successful at. Her team also includes Valerie who helps us do things like get things up onto YouTube, Anthony Taven, who does our social. And if you've ever gotten any swag from us, that probably came from Nikki Talbot. Finally, if you found us through a Spotify ad, which many of you did, you can thank my colleague, Chrissy Fedora. Now, I also want to give a shout out to my good friend, Reed Carlberg, for basically just always being there for me and being a huge supporter and somebody who's been a mentor in my professional career. And I definitely wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for him. But of course, finally, I want to thank you, the listeners. The feedback we've gotten has been amazing. I cannot tell you the joy that I have gotten out of doing this podcast. I think I've tried to say it quite a few times, but especially in the pandemic. It's interesting because when I talked to other podcasters, as the pandemic was rolling out, there were basically two forms of thought. One of those basically being, don't talk about the pandemic. A podcast is a safe, happy place. And it's a place people can go to kind of forget about the pandemic for, 30, 50 minutes. I think that's brilliant. There's nothing wrong with that strategy. But it was actually an interview with Mark Braga. And Mark had COVID-19 before he joined Salesforce. Like, he got hired at Salesforce and then instantly got COVID-19. And we talked about it so briefly on the podcast that I went back and I thought about it. And I was like, I think that might have been a mistake. Like, Mark might have been able to share some of his perspectives on something that other people are interested in, and he has a unique perspective on it, i.e. being a victim of COVID-19. And so it's just been wonderful to have these conversations with everybody during these times. And I want to thank you again. And we are going to episode 200. There's probably not a lot of huge changes coming up into the near future. Some of the things we're looking at doing is things like, again, putting in some of those long form conversations, maybe bringing back some of the audio that you haven't had a chance to hear. And we are also going to start bringing on some guest hosts. So you're going to start hearing a few other voices from this podcast, but trust me, they're all people that I respect and adore. Now, before we go, I want to play for you a little experiment that never really quite got off the ground. We created these parody radio ads that were intended to be shared with other podcasts and kind of used as sort of a community sort of advertisement kind of thing. The pandemic kind of disrupted everything. These ads were produced by my producer, Danny Osmond, and his team over at Emerald City Productions. I personally want to thank Danny and his team for being great partners and mentors and making sure that we have that insanely great high-quality sound that you are currently hearing. We have a handful of these. I want to play two for you today. We might play some of them later on, but the two that I want to play are two of my favorites. And the first one sounds a little bit like public radio.
You're listening to API Public Radio. Next week on Developer Voices for Your Stay-at-Home Pets, We will break down the geographic distinctions between regional uses of the semicolon and the lasting impact that kebab case has made on the development world. Our guests will be two developers with completely different grammatical styles who will need to answer compelling questions like tabs versus spaces, and whether it is acceptable to use variables named after family members. Catch Developer Voices for your stay-at-home pets every other Sunday or whenever you happen to download it.
That was the first one. I hope you enjoyed it. Fun fact, these originally ended with a cutover to me saying, well, that was fictional. Well, here's a real developer podcast for you. I'm cutting those for the sake of time. And also, if I'm being frank, my early audio wasn't that great. And now this next one, well, it's one of my favorites because it reminds me of one of my favorite things, which is old time cereals.
Last week on Captain Vapor, brought to you by the fine people at General Programmatic. The good captain saved the day by moving code into proper utility classes. But this week, she will face one of her greatest foes yet, the null pointers. Let's take a listen.
Captain, I don't understand. Everything was fine until we went to production. Now every page is nothing but errors.
Faithful sidekick, you fool! Your select statement is just pointing to the first index.
Of course, it might be an array, but I just need the record the user has access to edit. It's always the first one.
Unless they don't have access in production, don't you see? There's no first one! You've created nothing but null pointers as far as the eye can see! Oh, you've doomed us all!
Oh no! How will Captain Vapor save the day? Will Faithful Sidekick finally use a proper catch statement? Will he learn to check the array size before instantiating? Will production ever be stable? Tune in next week to find out!
Okay, well that's our show. Once again, I want to thank everybody who helped get us here, everybody who's been on the show, and as always, I want to thank you for listening. Now, if you want to learn more about this show, head on over to developer.salesforce.com/podcast. where you can hear old episodes, see the show notes, and have links to your favorite podcast service. Thanks again, everyone. I'll talk to you next week.